Hey guys, let's get savvy. Welcome to Get Savvy with Social, my media and lifestyle blog. Today, I'm going to be teaching you 4 digital tools that will keep you super organized. Also, before we begin, be sure to look down there and click subscribe. In this episode, I want to talk about how to get super duper organized with these 4 digital tools. I use these all the time, and ask anyone, they'll probably say I'm a little too organized. So if you want to start getting your life in order, or maybe it's in order and you want to get a little bit more on top of it, these 4 digital tools are guaranteed to get you on top of everything. First thing, my favorite thing, which I am completely obsessed with, is my calendar. I know, it may sound super lame, but once you start using it, trust me, you will love it. I got my husband to use it, and he was very opposed to it at first, and now he loves it too. So if he loves it, you'll love it. So my calendar, I use a digital calendar that syncs to my computer. So whichever digital calendar you choose, just make sure it could sync to a computer. So when I'm at work or when I'm on my computer, I can also access it. The next thing that I do with my calendar is I organize it into 4 colors. So you could choose colors depending on what you need it for. I have red for work items, green for appointments. I have purple for things that I just need to do that day, which aren't that important. I can maybe move around, more like to-do list items. And then blue, which is another appointment color like green, but one that overlaps with my husband. So that's the cool thing about calendars. You could also sync them to share with other people. So those are the 4 colors that I use and that I rely on. So I know if it's red, it's something very important for work. If it's green, it has a time limit to it, it's an appointment. If it's blue, it maybe has a time limit as well, but it's an activity I'm sharing with someone else, my husband in this case. And if it's purple, a to-do list item. So my calendar is something I get in the habit of checking in the morning and usually the night before I go to sleep so that I know what I have to do the next day. The next thing are notes. The Notes app is another digital tool that can help you stay on top of it all. So I have notes depending on what I need. I have a buy list, which includes my groceries. I have a dollar, dollar, dollar sign list, which is money, and I write down what I spend money on. So money, I have a work list. I have a general extra to-do list, things that I could look at in the future. I have a goals list. I even have a dreams list. Yes, I know, a little embarrassing, but I like to write down my dreams. So my list app acts a bit as a journal too, but it's just a place I can go and make sure I'm getting things done. And I know that I have everything in one place. So that also syncs from my phone to my computer using iCloud, and that makes it really easy for me to kind of keep on top of it all. So just like my calendar, I'm also in the habit of tracking my notes day to day. Number 3 is the clock app. This is another digital tool that is amazing. It's not just setting your morning alarm, right? So that's something we all probably use it for. You set an alarm, you may set a second alarm if you like to snooze. What I like to do is the night before I go to sleep, I like to look at what I have in my calendar the next day and see what appointments I have for work, what appointments I have in my personal life, and I like to make alarm timers to kind of remind me. Sometimes I set a timer 5 minutes in advance of a meeting, or if it's an activity where I need to drive somewhere, let's say an hour, I'll set a timer an hour in advance just to kind of keep me on top of things, because we all know it's super easy to let time fly by when you're busy, and this will really guarantee that you don't miss an important meeting. Digital tool number 4, email. We all use it. It could make some of us go completely insane. The number one thing with email for me is to make sure I go through and open it all. When I see 70,000 emails unread on someone's phone, that is like panic attack for me. So maybe you're someone who doesn't mind that, but my husband is one of those 70,000 people, and he misses my emails all the time, and it drives me insane. So if you never want to miss an email again and be on top of it all, just make sure you go through and read all of your emails, click open on them. It's not that hard. But let's say you're saying, okay, Olivia, well, I want to leave something marked unread because I might want to go back and look at it. Fantastic idea. And I think you should do that. But if everything else is marked as read, those few things that are unread will stand out. And a way to take this even further is part number 2 for email. I like to have folders. So I started getting into this when I started teaching at USC and getting a lot of emails from my students, when I started planning my wedding and I had a lot of emails for that, and I started organizing things into folder. Work, to do, USC wedding. So those are four folder examples that I have. And that's a way where I could also take those unread emails if I need to see them and put them in those folders. And then you just get into a habit of checking them. But if you're someone who maybe won't check their folders and will forget something important, keep it in your main email box, mark it unread, but just mark everything else as read. Now, number three for emails, part three, which I find very important, it's something I started doing this year. When I send an email to someone, often I want a response, and it's easy to forget about getting that response. So what I like to do is I like to turn that email into a draft. So I'll reply to so-and-so, let's say Mr. Doe, for example. I send Mr. Doe an email. I'm waiting on Mr. Doe to send me an email back, but I don't know when it will come, and I really don't want to forget about his reply. And when you're sending a lot of emails, you will forget. So what I like to do is after I send the email to Mr. Doe, I go into my sent and I reply to myself and I just leave it as a draft. This way I know that all of the emails in my draft box are responses that I'm waiting on that are important. And I also get into a habit of checking those day to day. So there you have it. Those are four digital tools for getting super organized and staying on top of it all. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to go to getsavvywithsocial.com and subscribe there as well. You'll get all of this cool digital info delivered straight to your inbox. Thanks again. I'm Olivia Smith, and this is Get Savvy with Social.